When my agent sent me the script for Lost Girls, I was like, okay, this is it. This is the moment where I'm gonna pause and I make this one happen. I think experience as a documentary filmmaker really translates to working with actors because it's really an interpersonal skill. And working with actors, while I studied techniques, it is just very much an interpersonal experience, and I loved that work. There have been excellent documentaries on this case. What I felt was extraordinary that really couldn't be covered in the documentaries were the internal struggles of the families who were going through this kind of, you know, terrible injustice of losing a loved one and having nobody care or look for them. The sort of the way in which that changed families, stretched them thin, but also healed frayed bonds, that was not something that we could explore in a documentary. I think Lost Girls is kind of the inverse of the true crime doc or the true crime fiction film in that it's really, you know, we normally focus on the police and what they do or what they don't do, or the criminal and what he did or she did. And this film is really the other side. It's really flipping the script, and it's the other side of that coin. It's what is the ripple effect on all the lives surrounding these crimes and the human drama in the world of the victims. What's so great about working with real people and real characters is you can make the film feel incredibly specific and specific to them. We knew Mari really liked crystals and Stevie Nicks, right? So that really informed the production design of her house, right? Like, because you can kind of, that creates a whole aesthetic. The other women who are big players in the film, we knew a lot about their styles and interests, and we were able to kind of really make each character very specific and very true to themselves. So little cues like that really helped inform the character. Of course, Zodiac, both thematically and visually, was a reference. I think A Most Violent Year, which was shot by Bradford Young, was another visual reference for me. Prisoners, the amazing Roger Deakins shot. The look of the film did so much great work in the storytelling. I'm a huge fan of Ozu, and in Tokyo Story, which was a film my cinematographer and I looked at and pulled references from, distance was created from the protagonist through kind of obscuring your protagonist beyond multiple frames. You know, there are ways in the beginning of the film where I really wanted Mari to be sort of almost obscured, like behind a frame, behind the counter in the kitchen that you couldn't really see her, down the hall, disappearing down the hallway. As the movie continues and Mari kind of confronts some of her demons and lets go of some of her self-hatred, you know, the film opens up, we're able to see her better. And you know, these are ideas that we take from the greats. I think I'm attracted to films which feature voices that we don't often get to hear. From my early days making films in prisons to, you know, today with Mari Gilbert, who had to, you know, fight so hard and continue to raise her voice in order to just get the most basic rights that we think were afforded as citizens. I love those stories. I love characters who are complicated, who you may not think that you like, but then you grow to admire and respect, and then, yes, love, hopefully. I like those toothy heroines. And I like a film about a lot of badass women, and that's what this film is.